Hello everyone, welcome to another stream. We will solve puzzles to improve our calculation and visualization skills. In the first puzzle, why to move? If you have any ideas, please tell. Help me to solve it. The first and most inviting move is bishop d5 check, because it's a forced move. Knight need to capture. Then queen takes g6 check. If king h8, then rook d4. Queen takes d4. Pawn takes d4, rook c1 check, king g2. Wow, okay. If e2, then queen h6, queen takes c1. Okay, so this looks good. If king f8, then rook f1 check, king e7, rook f7 check, king d8. Queen g8 check, queen e8, rook f8. Check. And captures. Okay, let's go for the next one. So white has so many pawns, black has so many pieces. Okay, rook h5 check, king takes h5, queen takes f5, king h6. Ah, there's a checkmate threat on e1. Oh, nice. Rook h5 check. Takes. Queen takes e4. D7, the pawn cannot be stopped. Oh, beautiful. This should be a checkmate probably somehow. Queen takes h6. Bishop takes h6. Rook takes h6. King g7. Rook h7 check, king f8. Rook g8 check, king h6. Knight f7 check, rook takes f7. g5 checkmate. Okay, nice. Yeah, thank you very much for the follow, thank you. So why to move? What do you think? How come? Ah, definitely. Thank you very much for the follow. Thank you. Sky Lake, thank you for the follow. So we should look for the sacrifices, I think here, like rook to g6, probably that looks the most likely. Rook takes g6, if pawn takes g6, then queen takes e6 check. King f8, then queen f6, king g8, queen takes g6, king h8, queen h7 checkmate. Queen f6. How to follow up? That's the question. So what's the follow up? King on f8, queen on g6. Maybe bishop h7 check, king h8, bishop f5. No, that's probably not good. That's probably not good enough. Rook takes g6, that's forced. Rook takes bishop. Rook takes g6. Pawn takes. And queen takes e6, check. King g7. Queen takes g6, check. King f8. Well, queen h6 is not working. Wow, what's going on here? Check, tick. So king is on g8, queen on f6, pawn bishop b1, rook on e1. Yeah, we can make a perpetual, but probably there should be something more than perpetual. Is there any kind of trick after the sacrifice? This looks challenging. Thank you for the civil cop. So, anybody has an idea here? I'm probably missing something. What else? Yeah, you know, maybe the thing is I just don't need to sacrifice immediately. Maybe there is something else. But queen is hanging, Queen f, yeah, the rook is on e1, is need to be protected. Really need to be protected? Let's look what other checks. Queen b8 check, not good. Probably takes queen h8, queen g7. All the other captures. Queen takes e6, queen takes d5, bishop takes g6. Attacking moves. Actually, his pieces are protected. So this rook to g6 looks pretty direct. Pawn takes. But the problem is queen h6 is not good, Florian, because queen takes h6, he has a queen on d2. I thought about that, but it's h6 square is just not viable. That's the big problem. Rook g6, pawn take g6, queen takes e6, king f8. Yeah, I missed that too also in the beginning. I think I looked this before, but something I'm missing. So let's look at bishop takes bishop h7. Bishop h7, king takes h7. Ah, the rook is open up. You just move the rook up then to h7. I know, somehow I missed that. Everything opens up. Yeah, that's simple. Rook e7 coming. Oh, nice checkmate. So, rook takes, pawn takes, queen takes. Queen g6, king f8, queen f6, king g. Yeah, and bishop e7, h7, and then rook e7. Yeah, the rook became free. Okay, let's move for the next one. White to move. Takes b7, bishop takes b7, bishop takes b7. Means the pawn. Okay, white to move again. Okay, this is tricky. This is white to move. Yeah, black is settling to checkmate on g2 or h2. So white is only, I think queen f8 is only move. King g5. Ooh, then okay, rook takes f5, pawn takes f5, then queen g7 checkmate. That's nice, but the rook takes f5, probably king g4 comes. Then rook g5, king takes g5, then queen f4 checkmate. King h3, then queen c8. Ah, I think queen c8 should be also good. But bishop e6 is forcing, yeah. Because then queen f1. Yeah, I can capture, so that's another nice one. Queen g7, check it then. So black to move now, black to move. What should black do? So, it should be like here. Queen d4 check, bishop takes d4, bishop takes d4. Okay, probably that's not just. Problem, rook f2. Yeah, I can still do like maybe castling long, castling short and attacking the f2 rook. But he can also play queen f2, so sacrificing back the queen. Yeah, for dear new viewers, few words about me. I'm Attila Turso, an international chess master and chess coach. I started to teach chess when I was 16 years old, that was 26 years ago. And I was teaching hundreds of students from all around the world, from absolutely beginners to masters. My best student became an international grandmaster. And she rated over 2600. He was one of the best 100 players of the world and won the national championship of Paraguay, Axel Backman. My usual student is a hobby player who likes to play chess over the board or online and would like to improve their chess, have more fun. Yeah, if you would like to study with me, feel free to send me a message on whatever platform you want, like chess.com or Twitch, YouTube or Twitter. I am happy to help you. I'm working on my goal to go and get the International Grandmaster title. I would like to do that to show people it's possible also in a little bit older age, because I'm 42 years old. Usually people who became grandmasters, they became in their teen years or in their 20s. So this would be kind of unusual to be a grandmaster in my age, but I will give my best to reach it. By watching this stream and or donating or subscribing, you can support me on my road. I would like to already thank you everybody for all their support. So back black to move. Some moment, maybe like something like knight g3 can be handy. What would black do here? Hmm. What should we do here? What should we do? Queen takes d3. Queen takes d3. Bishop takes e5. Yeah, pawn takes knight. It's a question, what will our h5 knight do? Maybe knight f4 can be good in some circumstances. Queen d4, bishop takes, queen f2. Bishop takes f2, rook takes f2. Knight g6, 7. Hello, Spooty, nice to see you. Yeah, if rook f2, then we have rook f8 probably, but what if queen f2? We should take it. Takes back with rook and knight g7 to save. Maybe the back, you know, the long diagonal is so strong, maybe you can think about attacking there. Something like queen d7 and then queen c6. What do you think about that? Thank you for the follow. Thank you. Thank you. Wow. These puzzles are hard. Exactly, are hard. But what am I missing? Oh, I have an idea. Queen d4, bishop takes d4, queen f2, knight f4 with the idea of checkmate on a3. Wow. Wow. Ha! I found it. Wonderful. And the checkmate in strat, that's the thing. Yeah, he's not forced to take, but if he moves to give space for the to winning a piece. Wow. Yeah, I just got an inspiration to look for checkmates. Wow. Okay, let's go for one more. Adok. So, bishop takes f6, king f7, king takes f7, queen e6 check, king f8, queen takes f5 maybe, king g8. Maybe just rook f1 and the idea of rook takes f5 after king f8. Yeah, that's it. Rook f1 with the idea of rook is coming, rook f5 is coming. Bishop moves, you just take it. Yeah, just going for the checkmate. Oh, nice one. Yeah, thank you everybody for who joined solving the puzzles, like Zuki, Joe, Bovin, Svefforst, Perez, Mikosin, Kiontovic, Florian. And thank you all everybody who subscribed, thank you for the donations, thank you all the help. Please try to put into practice all of these ideas in your own games.